In this presentation, we will set up a bank account within our general ledger. Get ready, because here we go with Xero. Here we are in our not-for-profit company dashboard. Now, there's a couple different ways we can go to set up our bank account, because the bank account's a little bit special in that you could have bank feeds with the bank accounts. Now, note, we're not going to be setting up bank feeds for this practice problem. We do have a course on bank feeds if you would like to check that out. But what you really want to do is get an understanding of how the not-for-profit works, so that then if you decide to have the bank feeds, you can then take that information that will flow in from the bank and allocate it properly to wherever it needs to be allocated to. If you don't have that understanding, then the bank feeds are going to be end up as kind of a mess, because what will happen is you'll get a lot of transactions from the bank, but you won't know how to categorize them properly, and therefore it's going to end up in kind of an overwhelming mess type of situation unless you know how to categorize those transactions. That's what we're focusing in on here. One way to get there is to go to the chart of accounts. This would be the standard type of way for any type of account that you were going to be adding, by going to the accounting dropdown and then going to the chart of accounts. So we're going to be going to the chart of accounts because, of course, we will be adding the account of the bank account. Now, the chart of accounts here is going to be organized by code, and then it's going to be organized in essence by type. So you want to think of the chart of accounts as being basically balance sheet and then the income statement, or in other words, assets, liabilities, equity, income, then expense, and then broken further down into things like subcategories, such as the liquidity of the assets. The more liquid the assets, such as cash being on top, then the current assets, and so on and so forth. So we're currently in the All Accounts tab. Xero has a nice little feature here where they actually break out the chart of accounts by category. So you have the assets, liability, equity, and so on and so forth, which is kind of nice. Normally, when you add a new account, you'd be going to the add account here. However, the bank account, because it's special, has special needs, including the bank feeds, if we choose to set those up, has its own little item where you're going to set it up here as add the bank account. Now, also note, when you add the bank account, this would be anything that would have like an institution, financial institution, where you could have bank feeds. So credit cards, in other words, would also be added with this add bank account item, even though they're liabilities, which is a little bit funny, but it works because it's going to go through the same process. It'll flip that account to be a liability if you have bank feeds, because it'll be a negative amount. So just something to keep in mind. It's a little confusing for me at first, but it actually works quite well. Now, the other way you can get into the bank feeds is you do the accounting drop down and then go into the bank accounts. So you go into the accounting and then into the bank accounts, and you'll get to the same kind of setup screen. Now, it's going to ask you to set up the bank accounts to connect. You don't have to do the connection, but you have to go through the kind of the startup process of it just to set up a bank or a cash type of account. So we're going to go ahead and add a bank account. So I'm going to say this is going to be the bank account. I'm now going to choose a bank, even though I'm not going to use the actual bank. So you could choose the bank even if you're not going to make the connection to that bank. And then you could choose to make the connection at a later point in time. So I'm just going to say Chase here, automatically import your Capital One transactions. I'm going to say no. I'm going to go ahead and actually I chose Capital One. Sorry, Capital One. And I'm going to say skip that. I'm not going to be importing the transactions. And then next item. Account name. I'm going to put the account name as just the checking account. Now, you might want to put like the last four digits of the account number or something like that if you want to be able to tie into it, or the name of the institution, if that would be easier to go with. The more checking, if you have multiple different checking accounts you're working with, it could be nice, of course, to have some kind of distinguishing factor like the last four digits of the the bank account number or something like that. And then the account type, I'm going to say it's going to be the everyday. I'm going to go with the everyday account number. I'm just going to put numbers here. Obviously, this isn't going to tie out. I'm going to put a number here. This is not the number of the chart of accounts. They're looking for the account number for the bank account. So you can put the actual bank account number, but if you don't want to, you need to put some number there, and you should be able to push forward with it. So add another Capital One US. No, I'm going to go ahead and continue then. So we're going to go ahead and continue. And there we have it. It's now set up. Now, of course, this big green button says get bank feeds. We're not going to be doing that. What I want to do is go back to the chart of accounts now. So if I go to the accounting dropdown, and we then go to the bottom item, which is the chart of accounts, not the very bottom, but pretty close to the bottom, second to last item there. We're going to go into the chart of accounts. Then we'll see at the top of the chart of accounts, the checking account. So here's going to be the checking account. And that's going to be a bank type of account, which is, of course, a type of an asset type of account. Now, we didn't assign a number to it. We might want to go in and sign like a code number to it, which is basically an account number. So to do that, I could click on the checking account here and assign a code. Let's just make it 1100. And then I'll go ahead and save that. So I'm going to save that. And the code number, note, you kind of want to keep in alignment with basic accounting number kind of activities here, which is basically the checking account starts with the ones, and then the accounts receivable with a 1-2, and then a 1-3 for the other asset type of accounts. And then liabilities are going to start with a 2,000 and so on and so forth. So you want to have space between those numbers, or else it will get messy. You want to make sure you have a good grouping between the account numbers. So now we have our checking account set up. That's going to be our basic account. We're going to be needing to be entering our transactions in our not-for-profit organization, which we will continue to do in following presentations. That's it for now. Let's get out of here.